Good evening. And today we're going to have another lesson about bookmarks. And today we're going to specifically look at ribbon tangles that will go great down the middle of our bookmarks. So I'd like to begin by showing you something real quick here. This is a little tan mixed media pad of paper. It's a card. It's like the card that if you've bought any of the Strathmore 4x4 inch cards, it's that paper. But you can get it in this little pad with 15 sheets. The sheets are 6 inches by 8 inches. So you can get 4 bookmarks off of each page, and there are 15 sheets. So that's 60 bookmarks, and that's a heck of a deal. So anyway, there you go. If you want to make, just keep bookmarks around to make and give to people. The second thing I'm going to show you is the screen sharing part. I want to take you, all right, I'm going to punch this screen share, Tangle patterns, share. All right. There we go. Can you see tanglepatterns.com on your screen?
Yes.
Good. All right. That's what I want you to see. So this is a website put together by this noble woman. Mm-hmm. She does this as a labor of love, and she's been doing it for a long time. Her name's Linda Farmer, and she probably earns enough to pay her computer bill, maybe a little more, but it is an incredible resource. It's not real slick on the front and fancy, but you can find a wealth of information on this website. She has put together tangles from all over the world that she gathers, and she's built relationships with these people and so forth. And let's see. There we go. She has a weekly, well, I should say several times a week. I don't remember, 4 or 5 days a week, she sends out a newsletter with a new tangle each day and a little story about the tangle itself or the person who created it, who figured it out, saw from a resource or something. And she takes you then, if you read through all of it, well, this is her opening page, but let's just, I'm going to do this and see where that takes me here. Okay. This was, okay. Something's not right there. So, and these are things that she advertised, I mean, that are advertised on there to help her afford to be able to do this and keep it free. And so there she's telling about it. And then she talks about this tangle created by Lisa Kostick, who's a CZT, and gives you the step out right there. Now, sometimes people have published the step outs on their own blogs or their own sites, in which case she supplies you a link to that place. and you can click through to that. And the cool thing about that is then you can see how they used it in various tiles. Some people give more, some less, but it's really valuable. So, okay, you have that, but you probably don't want to flip through every day. So you can also buy, which I can't show you right now. I don't, maybe I can. Let's see what happens here. Can you see this? Can you see the PDF? No, no, you're still seeing tangle patterns. Okay, so this didn't work. I will get back to here then. I'll show you that resource in another day. She has an ebook with over 1,000 tangles in there, little squares of them. And then you can click on them and it'll take you to the page that shows you how to draw it to the step out or whatever. But this is maybe and she sells those little guides for like $20, I think now. And she comes out with them annually. I buy them myself as much as anything to support her work, but I really use them too, because you have all these little things on one page, page after page after page, and you can scan through them pretty quick. But over here in the left-hand margin, you can go to this Tangles by Type. So you click on that, and what you see is all different types of tangles. And let's say you wanted to do Christmas tangles. Bingo. All right. So there are just a whole bunch of Christmas type tangles that can be turned into various things. And then you keep going and going, and you can get down to the bottom. And then there's the next page with more Christmas type tangles. Or you could go over here and you could say, I want to do tangles that are organic. So these are tangles that grow, that look like you can just add on to them, coming up out of the ground. Let's see. And these are tangles from people all over the world, but they're all organized here. But the one I want to show you next is, did I go too fast there? Were you able to see that well enough, pretty much? I need to slow down too a little bit. Since we're looking at bookmarks, that's a long, narrow tile. I went to ribbon tangles. And so all of these tangles in one way or another can be ribbons. You could just take them right down the middle of the bookmark. And I think that she had picked out about 560 of them. So that would keep you busy for more than a week, I think. And certainly there are more out there. This is not an exhaustive list of tangles, but it is a whole bunch. And when you start following these links, you'll probably start finding other links on the person's site. Maybe they have other tangles that aren't on this resource yet, but you can certainly never run out of tangles. But the good thing about this, though, is that it it categorizes them in a way. And you can look on here where you go tangles by type, spirals, grids, triangles, voice guided tangling, weaving tangles, zigzag tangle, scales, rice shapes, radial, organic orbs, OG grid, hexagons, hearts, freeform, on and on. And this is completely free. You just go to tanglepatterns.com. Tangle patterns, all one word. So when I went to, let's see, I'm on ribbon tangles right now. This was the first page. And I scrolled down and I found this one. So I can click on this article. And here's some beautiful lupines. And here she shows how to, how it kind of goes and was used in a quilting pattern. And then down here at the bottom, she's got the step out of how you do it. Now I'm gonna, this is the one we're gonna work on today somewhat. I'm gonna draw it slightly different from hers. Well, no, I didn't mean to do that. What I meant to do was that. And I'll show you why a little bit later, why I've changed the steps just a little bit, but you come out very much, very close to the same. Okay. Then I wanted to find a border for this, and I went over a couple of pages. I can get back up here. And the little border that I found, it turns out, was also by the same tangler. And I wasn't even looking at her name. Come on, let's see. Maybe it's the third page. You can see there's Marley. We've done that. I considered doing this one, Mirranda. It's really good. Well, anyway, maybe it's on page two. I don't know. All these different things that you can do. All right, I'm not gonna worry about it. It's a good idea when you are scrolling through things. If you find one you like, I have learned this the hard way, write it down on a little in your notebook. If you see something you really like, because the chances are you may not be able to find it again, or it'll be real hard. So just make it a habit to write the things down. This time, that interwoven piece was by the artist. Let's see. No, that's not what I want. Let's see. Well, maybe she's only doing this. I hadn't looked at this. Maybe it's only last name she's looking at them. Well, I don't know. I can't find it there. But anyway, it's Ria Mathessen. Now, I'm going to shut this off. There is a lot more to this website, but I'm going to shut it down looking at it at this point. That really is for resources for a Tangler. That website probably has more and better stuff than any other one I found. It even tops out the Zentangle.com, because Linda Farmer has gathered together so many resources, and she's so gracious to not just list the pattern with a person's name, but she tells you a little bit about them, how if the people have written about what made them create that tangle, that's there too. And it's very rich in what it offers, and it's free. So with that, I'm going to switch to my document camera and show you some stuff. When we talk about making these bookmarks, we already know a lot of things we can put into that space. This is a tangle that we learned, we've used it a couple of different times. It's called Elegans, and it's just so beautiful. You could make it even a little bigger, or you could make it like this and then put some decorations around it, and it would just really be very elegant bookmark. This is one called Trimond that would be neat. This is that elegance that I used as a border around, you know, a central thing. And you can see where doing it and color, using a lot of contrast. This is actually a white tile that I've filled in with a lot of black. Here's a cool one, Noodles, it's very organic, and you can, I think especially when you color this one, it could be quite fascinating. And you could put pearls in the middle or not, or noodles. Here's one, you may remember back when I was trying to figure out an easy way to do Celtic knots, that too would make a neat bookmark to do weaving like that. Here's one. I can't remember the name of this one. I should, but it's basically a square printemps, and it makes an interesting frame. Here's another frame. If you had something on a bijou that you wanted to frame and put up, we've done that before. And so these ribbon tangles are really good for that. Here's one I liked, and it's really pretty simple. but would be a lot of fun in the coloring of it. I could just see these all different colors and sparkles and little shooting stars and whatever. Thought it'd be great. Here's an organic ribbon tangle called Tipple Skew. And okay, I've done that one. And then finally this one. I worked on it. And then it's called Mirranda. I worked on it several different versions. But somehow I just wasn't taken with it in getting it as elegant looking as I thought it could be. And so I'm going to work on it and maybe bring it to you again in a week or two. I don't know. And then there's this one. And it is called, what did I say? Walu by Ria Mathessen. The first one I drew based on her instructions was this one. And the lapping over of the leaves on this line didn't seem to work as well as I wanted it to. And so I tried it a different way here, and it overlaps a little better. Now, when she did hers, these things were closer in together. I spread them further out. You know, it is what it is. Finally, this is what I worked on and finished. I'm not going to say it's totally finished, but more or less finished today. I still think I want to put some gold on it. And I don't know, curlicues and fun stuff. So with that, we're going to work on this. And start in the middle. If you want to work on, if you have a Renaissance tile, it's a bookmark, fine. But I was mainly just trying that paper out, but a white one will work just fine and we will adapt from that. So there's my white. Okay. Well, let's take a little sip of Coke or whatever we've got sitting next to us and lay our tile before us. I'll be working with a micron PN or a larger micron if you've got it. If you don't worry about it. With a micron 01. So I've got a PN and an 01 and a pencil. And a tortillon. And I also decided to use the brown pen as well. I think that the leaves being in a different color makes a nice contrast. And I think it'll work well even on the white paper. So let's give that a shot. We'll gather our thoughts. Breathe. Okay. And then that's a little better. So let us take a moment to appreciate what we have, even if times are tough. Appreciate our friends, our family, and anything else that comes to mind. And then we can begin with our dots. I'm gonna pull this up a little bit. And then our lines. And next, we would say we're going to put down our string. And our string for this exercise is going to consist of a second frame. I'm going to aura the inside that first frame. And I'm narrowing in on that space, that center space, to make it easier to center what we're doing. Not that it'll be perfect, but it may be a little better. And so from this point to this point, I'm gonna draw a wavy line. Not going all the way to the edge, but just mainly partway, I guess, not like that. And just take it up, down, up, and down, like that. Doesn't have to be perfect, no mistakes. And then we can turn our tile and we can go the other way and cross those sort of in the middle. Okay. And if they're a little wonky, well, it'll just have more character. Okay. So what we're looking for here is a way to cross over something without the bottom showing through, what goes behind showing through. And so we kind of have to leave gaps and then come back later and fill them in based on what we've done. And I will tell you right now that this line I've gone over twice, once with my 01, and then once again with a little bit thicker line or a little bit heavier hand, so that the line looks, ends up looking a little more even, and we don't have these little things. It just brings an elegance to what we're drawing that I couldn't figure out any other way to do. Somebody else maybe could, but that's where I was. So we're going to start by making a series of S's, so to speak. We're going to go here to here. And then, yeah, all right. I think this is right. And if I need to start over, well, we'll start over on the back. So we start leaving a gap near where the lines cross. We start there. And this is going to be the over. Let me do it first, and then I stop about there. So this is going to be, that's going to be our guide for this. And we can continue doing that. So then we'll come to this side. And there. Okay. So it should look something like that. Take your time. And now, we're going to aura these lines twice on either side. We're going to go from right there and draw slowly and surely an aura. And then here, right there. And right there. Relax your hand. Turn your tile if you need to. And then draw a second aura. On the same side as where we were before. Right there. So this pencil line that we drew is our center line, and there are going to be two auras on either side of that center line. And when you've done those, let's turn it around and we're going to add auras on this side, two auras on the inside of that. Make it a nice wide. Well, eventually this will be a nice wide ribbon. Okay. If you've got a brown pen or any other color if you like. I have somewhere around here, I have some other microns that are in colors, but I'm just going to use the brown because it's here. And I think most of you have that. And then we're going to follow this line, the second line. And we just weave it through. Like that. One of the things that this brown pen does is it kind of helps you to see the two different elements that are twisted together. I'm going to kind of emphasize this a little more. You may even want to just increase the line weight a little bit. Make the line a little heavier in places. Kind of smooth it out. And we can add our little leaf patterns. And you can either make them small, or you can make them large, or you can make them both small and large. Just go for it. Sometimes maybe drawing behind, and other times not. When you come up to where the brown line goes under that black, your leaves can go under as well. And you just, you know, let the tips go under there like it's really behind. Okay. Well, y'all take your time and I'll just sit here for a minute. Okay. Does anybody need a little break? Okay. I'm going to go back with my 01 black. And I'm gonna connect the dots, so to speak, even though there are no dots, but I'm gonna take those black lines and run them right up. Now, a little hint maybe. You see right there, there is a little dot where I put my pen down the second time. You might wanna land your airplane in a place like that, kind of come in, start back behind. That's really tricky to make that smooth. If your pressure is different, if your speed at drawing your pen across your paper is different, you're going to leave more or less ink. Here I'm starting away and I'm drawing into the line. That seems to work pretty well. You'll have to figure out what works well for your hand. Another way you could do it is just to go ahead and draw your initial lines on this black wave with a pencil, lightly, the whole smear, and then draw the leaves over and under to get it to look smooth then, and then come back and do the lines to get them to look nice and smooth. You see right now, it's kind of my advanced collapse here. But you see how the lines are uneven and look a little, I don't know, like I stopped and started. And there's times when And that's fine, that's wonderful. But there are times maybe when you want things to look real smooth. So what I'm gonna try is taking this PN and with a steady, even hand, tracing slowly over the black lines. very carefully. In the Zentangle world, we often call this giving it some love. And you can maybe even wait until you've finished everything and come back and retrace over lines. Sometimes using a larger, slightly larger pen or a heavier hand. Okay. Now we've got this very heavy basic line sort of thing going down the middle. And we need to kind of balance that heaviness with our leaves as they go down. And so what I did on here was just to make the leaves white. And that was some, that black and white I thought kind of balanced well. But on here, I got up a minute ago and got my colored pencils out. And let's see what that looks like. The color isn't exactly what I want. That may look more like it. There we go. I think I may just lightly do this. You may not have your colored pencils there with you. You probably could just go ahead and color them in with the graphite too. That would be another way. Just lightly. Ah, so got it kind of looking like that now. Okay. Now we're going to work on our little border, and it's called Tiwa, T-I-W-A, by Ria Mathessen. We'll take a minute at the end to write these on the back. And she modeled this after some tiles that she saw. But what we're going to do, I'm going to use my PN, my black PN, and I'm going to go and just trace over the lines, the pencil lines that we had in the beginning. You can straighten them out or you can leave them a little wonky. Okay. So then we can put in these little squares, and we put them kind of cattywampus to that. So they look like diamonds. And when I do things and I want to center them, I often work from the ends toward the middle. Like here, I went and did the corners, then I went to the middle, and then I went to the middle of this, and then they were relatively evenly spaced. I thought about putting extra ones in here, but I decided that was enough. So Now, let's take and draw a line here. This is so simple, but I think it's kind of elegant, and it reminds me of the stained glass you often see in windows and doors, that kind of diamond thing. I know, Jenny, you do stained glass artwork. You've probably made borders that look something like this. Okay. Now I'm going to take my graphite pencil, a little stub, and just go along on this outside little piece here. And then take your tortillon and gently work it into the paper, the graphite. And then I think it would look good if we went around and shaded this. Here. Well, I think I'm about ready to stick a fork in it. And I'll take a minute or two more. And I think one of the main things we learned here today is a technique for making things look twisted, taking two ribbons and twisting them somehow over and under. It's not entirely simple, but it can be effective. One thing we could do here is maybe even, especially if we had markers, we could color this in and color these in with more color. But that you can do on your own, maybe give it another try. And think of different ways to make it, different ways to draw it, narrower, wider. So let's go ahead and put our little chop on it. turn it over and sign it. Let's see, it's the 17th, I think. Just so we can remember what tangles we used. There they are. T-I-W-A and W-A-L-U by Ria. Mathessen. Any questions or comments or anything at this point? No?
No, thank you. That was really nice. I enjoyed that.
Okay, good. Well, I really enjoyed tangling with you gals, and I'll see you all next week.